Hello guys, this is Rich Rich TV and welcome back to my channel. But before I start the devotional guys, I would like to shout out to pala yung Preacher Channel na napunta rito at nag-join sa devotional. Shout out ang God bless to Leo Bacoteco, Bon Anthony Balmoria, French and Dog, Vince Lawrence Chonko, Nathaniel Abelia, Michaela Lazaro, Mary Jane Espares, Ashley Moreno, Trixie Claire, Kim Incaso, Neil Bisnar, Alan Llagas, Kyle Dawadjas, Dale Ramos, Lilian Lobitos, Kim Lago, Heart Consalan, Mami Rose, Crop, Yance TV, Connie Blog, Pimbert Tolpo, Retro Blog, Michael Aburita, Formans Work, Jocelyn Custodio, and SSC TV of Korea. Shoutout na rin sa mga hindi nakisabay na manood at makinig sa devotional, but still, nagpunta pa rin dito para manood at makinig sa devotional. God bless us all, guys.
TV. Where you heard it, number one is on the top. Good advice is to never stop. Fish TV. Where you heard it, number one is on the top. Good advice is to never stop.
Thanks God, it's Friday at makapagpahinga na naman tayo, no, sa bukas. So, sulitin natin yung day natin, guys, no. Ngayon, tulog tayo ng maimbing, kaya nga, did you notice, I always say, have a good night rest, so you could gain strength for tomorrow's activity, di ba? So, kailangan natin yan. Kaya, before we sleep talaga, we need to have our devotional. And at the same time, you also have to pray for yourself. And I know, God will really bless you. Okay guys, let's now proceed to our devotional. Let's open the Bible to Genesis chapter 21, verses 8 to 21. This is about Hagar and Ishmael sent away. Still, guys, I'm using the devotional study Bible because the word you see is so simplified na maintindihan talaga natin. Okay, the word of the Lord in Genesis chapter 21, verses 8 to 21 says, the child grew and was weaned, and on the day Isaac was weaned, Abraham had a great feast, but Sarah so that the son of whom Hagar the Egyptian had born to Abraham was mocking. And she said to Abraham, get rid of that slave woman and her son, for the slave woman's son will never share the inheritance with my son Isaac. The matter distressed Abraham greatly because it concerned his son. But God said to him, do not be so distressed about the boy and your maidservant. Listen to whatever Sarah tells you, because it is through Isaac that your offspring will be reckoned. I will make the son or the maidservant into a nation also, because he is your offspring. Early the next morning, Abraham took some food and skin of water and gave them to Hagar. He set them on her shoulder and then sent her off with the boy. She went on her way and wandered in the desert of Beersheba. When the water in the skin was gone, she put the boy under the one of the bushes. Then she went up and sat down nearby, about a bow shoot away, for the thought, I cannot watch the boy die. And as she sat there nearby, she began to sob. God heard the boy crying, and the angel of God called to Hagar from heaven and said to her, what is the matter, Hagar? Do not be afraid. God has heard the boy's crying, and as he lies there, lift the boy up and take him by the hand, for I will make him into a great nation. Then God opened her eyes, and she saw a well of water. So she went and filled the skin with water and gave the boy a drink. God was with the boy, and he grew up. He lived in the desert and became an archer. While he was living in the desert of Paran, his mother got a wife for him from Egypt. Amen and amen. Okay, guys, let's now pray. Father God, this is the second time that Hagar was sent off by Sarah. But because it's not only Hagar, but she has Ishmael, the Lord bless Ishmael. And God knows what they're suffering, but bless them. And you promise Ishmael to be a great nation. Lord, this is really the consequences, Lord God, not listening unto you. Forgive us, O God, for many times we do things on our own without consulting you first. That's why I pray, Father God, to please forgive us. Lead us, guide us, that we may not suffer for the consequences of what we have done, particularly in the decision making. Lord, I pray that you may bless each one who are here. Open up our hearts, mind, body, soul, and spirit, that we may understand your word this evening and meditate on it also, and apply the word we hear this evening for ourselves. So, Lord, we commit all these things to you in this sermon, pray. Amen and amen. The focus verse we have for this evening, guys, is found in Genesis chapter 21, verse 11. It says, the matter distressed Abraham greatly because it concerned his son. So, ano naman? Masaktan ka talaga kasi anak mo yan. No? Pero yung kalaban mo, asawa mo rin. Di ba? Grabe talaga. The choices is so difficult. So, the title of our devotion for this evening, guys, is The Cost of Obedience. After 25 years of waiting, the Lord was gracious to Sarah and did what he promised. Isaac was born on God's exact timing. Imagine what went well on the mind of Abraham and Sarah as they waited for the miracle of Isaac to happen. So you think their faith in God wavered at some point? Probably, no? Sa haba ng panahon. The name Isaac means laughter. Abraham and Sarah first laughed at the impossibility of having a child in their old age. But God turned their skeptical laughter into joy. In the naming of Isaac and his circumcision, Abraham kept the covenant. Ito yung binasa natin before sa chapter 17, verses 9 to 12. The day Isaac was weaned, Abraham held a great feast. But Sarah saw the son whom Hagar had borne was mocking. The Hebrew root word used means to laugh, male voluntarily. Sarah was concerned that Ishmael had evil intention against Isaac, and so she pressed Abraham and get rid of them. So binasa natin kanina sa verse 10. Abraham was distressed with Sarah's demand. Ishmael was Abraham's natural son by Hagar. Paternal love explains this distress. He took this to God, who clearly told him to listen to Sarah. Abraham obeyed without harshness or cruelty. He trusted God's command to send Hagar and Ishmael out of his house with suitable provision. Surely Abraham must have been deeply touched as he watched Hagar and Ishmael go off into the distance. Amen and amen. Although it's really a great scene, yun din yung ano kasi, no, nangyari, wala tayong magawa, nangyari na yun because of Sarah's command na makipagsiping si Abraham kay Hagar so they could bore a child. Then nangyari talaga. Then, because of God's promise na Abraham and Sarah would bore a child, then ito na nga, nagsilos na naman si Sarah. Kaya pinapalayas niya si Hagar at si Ishmael. So, masakit on the part of Abraham pero wala siya magawa because the Lord's instruction for Abraham is to obey Sarah. Kaya obedient na talaga si Abraham. Ikaw kaya, no? Pag yung anak mo pinapalayo, no, sa'yo, masakit talaga. I could feel the pain of Abraham's heart na yung anak niya is lumalayo sa kanya. Anak niya rin yun. Although maid servant. si Hacker. Pero anak niya rin yan. Masakit. No? Masakit. Na-feel ko talaga yung sakit. But we can do nothing about it because God allowed it to happen. Sana di mangyari sa atin ang mga ganitong sitwasyon. Kasi masakit talaga. So, let's pray and adjust ourselves kung ano ipapagawa ni Lord sa atin if we are in this situation. I guess let's not pray. Not every step of our obedience to God is easy, Lord. But obeying God is always right. Thank you, dear God, for teaching us in this matter. Amen and amen. Yes, guys, wala tayong magawa if this is the situation. But except that we have to adjust ourselves and accept the reality. God bless us always because in the world, short verses, 10 times better. This again, Rich Rich TV. Kita-kita tayo muli. Hanggang sa muli. Paalam.